I always expected we would see it someday, so the question was only when.
Well, the collaboration with, I will call it the Max Planck Group, has been long and wonderful. Well, that was one of the things that gave me the confidence to do a study of a large baseline detector, which the NSF did support.
At first, Einstein thought gravitational waves might exist, but they would be too weak ever to be detected.
When I joined the field and first looked at the sensitivity that is required to detect gravitational waves, I thought that would be very hard, close to impossible.
100 years after the first steps, we finally have detectors that are sensitive enough.
We contributed lots of the technology that enabled this detection, that enabled improving the sensitivity to this incredible level that now we can see sources that are so far away.
The search for gravitational waves involves large collaborations of scientists all around the world. The two largest detectors are the LIGO detectors in the United States, which are operated by Caltech and MIT. LIGO Lab has organized the LIGO Scientific Collaboration around these detectors.
Advanced LIGO is actually using things delivered by people who worked on the GEO project.
We have developed a very stable laser at the Albert Einstein Institute to reduce the laser noise. The heart of this detector, which allows the measurement to be made. The laser that we provided for the advanced LIGO detectors is the most stable laser that we have in the world currently.
People from here in Glasgow have spent a significant time developing the suspensions and helping install them out in the US.
The breakthrough moment, the moment when I saw that we could realize an instrument that could have a factor of 10 over the sensitivity of initial LIGO, which was the goal given ourselves, was when the notion of a all-fused silica suspension system was developed.
We have provided suspensions for the main mirrors in the instruments, and those are improved and enhanced versions of the suspensions that were created for GEO 600.
In GEO, we have a long history of thinking always a generation ahead, of trying something which is risky, new, promising, doing things that you can only do on a small scale when you're not spending hundreds of millions of dollars. And then all these things that we have been working on over the years, they're now in advanced LIGO, and they work beautifully.
When the event happened, it was 3 o'clock in the morning at LIGO Hanford and 5 o'clock at LIGO Livingston. Fortunately, it was noon in Germany and everyone here was at work.
We saw a very strong gravitational wave signal, much stronger than we were expecting.
So people here in Europe first saw it, by the way, the people at the Max Planck in Hannover.
This institute is somewhat unique because we have here under a single roof experts who are involved in all the different aspects.
Andy?
So Marco Drago could just walk down the hall to show Andy Lundgren what he had found. Andy is an expert at characterizing the data.
Let's have a look at it.
Was this real or just a fake signal injected for testing purposes?
These data analysis pipelines are very important because they're what's watching the data to tell us if something's there.
The instrument doesn't end at the output where the light from the interferometers is recombined. It ends with the computers that watch for events and analyze the data to see if something has happened. ATLAS in Hanover was built for this purpose. It's the largest computer cluster in the world devoted to gravitational waves.
It's amazing.
It's perfect.
When I first saw the signal, I thought that can only be an injection. It's way too beautiful to be real.
I think we need to figure out if this is an injection.
Like a control room. We got a phone call, and Marco's called in to see, to let us know that they received the event also.
Okay.
You know, just to check and make sure everyone was locked, everything was okay, all hands was off.
Nobody was injecting as best as we could, and it looked more and more real.
Yeah. Who? I mean, if this is real, we need to do something.
It's like from a textbook. So it's almost too beautiful to be true.
So this is a graph that shows about half a second of our data. We saw exactly the gravitational wave signal we would get from two black holes that orbit each other and then merge together. The red and green are data from the two detectors. Here, the two black holes are orbiting about 20 times per second. Each orbit makes two gravitational wave cycles. As they fall together, the black holes get closer and speed up to about 75 orbits per second. When the black holes are a few hundred kilometers apart, they merge to form a single black hole.
If it were true, would be, you know, wonderful, because it was the perfect source that I could have ever dreamed.
So a lot of my attention in those first hours was actually on the question of how could we be sure that this wasn't a mistake that we'd made.
We have to make very sure that it has not been other noise.
We have more than 100,000 additional signals that we measure and store and that we can look at once we have seen something which could be a gravitational wave.
We in fact have long checklists.
In this case, we didn't find anything that could have caused the signal.
The second way we fight this noise is that we run multiple detectors.
The two instruments here are both in the United States, and they're 3,000 kilometers apart from each other. And the fact that the same signal was seen at both instruments at the same time is very critical for us.
And therefore, we are very confident that this is a gravitational wave.
So, in fact, we have made a discovery. So we have found a binary black hole system. This is the most exciting event of my life by far.
We developed a model of the effective one body calibrated to numerical relativity with spins, spins only aligned, which is actually the model that then has been used for the search. We met with the people in my division that are members of the LIGO Scientific Collaboration. And because there are people with different expertise, there were many things we wanted to do. So the people that were running the search, of course, they continue to do that. We wanted to actually finalize as soon as possible a better model that we had that included the precession of the spins.
And the reason for being in a rush to complete this work was that we wanted to apply this improved model to the analysis of the data.
The works in the week afterwards were to characterize the data, to understand what was there, and to prepare this modeled search that would run to be ready to quote a significance for this event at the 5 sigma level or the 1 in 10,000 year level that we need to confidently say this is actually the first observation of a gravitational wave signal here on Earth with gravitational wave interferometers.
Then we started this numerical relativity simulation because we wanted to compare the event directly with the best solution of the Einstein equations. But also we wanted to understand whether the analytical models used in the search were accurate enough.
It was super exciting. And almost right away, I was asked to produce a numerical relativity waveform that would reproduce the parameters of the event.
So we did that. And then also we started this follow-up studies to infer the astrophysical and physical information from the event. Because once you have detected the signal, you really want to know what are the parameters of the system. And we need an accurate waveform to do that.
We have to rely on those models to get the best possible science.
What are the masses of the two black holes? What are the spins? Where is located the binary in the sky? What is the distance from us to the binary? All this information are imprinted in the waveform. The follow-up analysis have revealed that the binary system was composed of two black holes, which had 36 and 29 solar masses. The two black holes merged into a single rotating black hole with a mass about 60 times the mass of the Sun, and the binary was 1.3 billion light years away. You can also test whether general relativity is the right theory in the strong field regime, because we are seeing not just the in-spiral part of the signal, but also the merger part. You know, when the two black holes merge together, this is something that has never, never been seen before.
So here there's two significant things in this discovery. The first is that we've shown that we can actually detect and measure gravitational waves. The other thing is that we've shown that another important prediction of Einstein's theory, the existence of black holes and their behavior, is also correct.
It's really opening a new era for physics and astrophysics and the knowledge of the dark side of our universe.
Suddenly, gravitational wave astronomy will be mainstream, because that's the goal. We don't just want to detect them. We want to do astronomy with them. And for that, it's not enough to have a single event. We want to have many. So we want to listen to this every day.
Good job.